This is Prachi Sharma from Trade Fair TV, and I'm back again with another exciting exhibition taking place at Citco Exhibition Center, Mumbai. You must be wondering, what is this exhibition all about and which exhibition is taking place here today? Well, I would like to tell you, it's called FinBridge 2016. And what is it all about? It is all about financial services and technology industry. So you must be wondering, what is FinBridge all about? FinBridge is India's premier trade show catering specifically to financial services and technology industry, the industry which is ever evolving and changing. FinBridge gives all the participants a one roof exhibition for them to display all their products and their offerings to their target audience. FinBridge, you get to collaborate, communicate, and connect with all the decision makers and financial investors under one roof. It is a lifetime opportunity to know about your financial intermediators and decision makers and expand your business. You do not want to miss out on this, so let's go inside and let's check it out. We are at FinBridge and we are sitting with Mr. Deepak Shah, the technical analyst for stock market. Well, thank you so much, sir, for joining us and welcome to the show. Sir, please tell me that what is this exhibition all about? I'm sure the mutual fund industry and the brokers and bankers will be definitely benefited out of it, but I would want you to elaborate on it.
See, this is the place where all the financial needs can be catered by the individual investor. Here you are getting mutual funds, you are getting brokers, you are getting best of the software from where you can trade even without using your brain. You are getting the automated systems. With that system you can trade successfully, you can invest successfully and plan out the things. And the way in which FinBridge is doing the business, I mean, they are giving the best of the facilities available in Bombay. Last year also we enjoyed with the FinBridge.
Do you think that such exhibitions about mutual funds, banking, investors and broking firms, do you think they are very beneficial for the industry, for financial service industry?
Yes, definitely it is going to be beneficial to the industry also and to individual investor also.
How do you think exhibitors and visitors and investors and financial services and brokers, in long term, how do you think that this industry will grow or evaluate or evolve?
This industry is likely to be growing not less than 10% per annum. And investing world is day by day increasing, and they need the right information at right time. And this can be done with the help of FinBridge.
Do you think that these kind of exhibitions should happen annually, or they should happen quarterly, or they should happen after every 2-3 years? What is your take on that?
First of all, I will congratulate all the management part, and it should at least once in a six month, this exhibition should take place.
Sitting with Niji Sayur, AVP Marketing. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
How do you see this exhibition benefiting all the exhibitors and visitors?
Exhibition will benefit definitely for the visitors. Like, you know, we have organized the conferences, whereas, like, you know, there are so many, like, you know, sessions, like, you know, financial advisor summit, which will help the visitors how to plan on their financial planning. And there's algo trading is also happening, which also, like, you know, it is actually like a session, workshop kind of a thing, which once a person attends it, like, you know, he can get out from here and he can become like an algo trader. That's one thing. And for the exhibitors, I mean, like, we are doing like all the marketing stuff, like, you know, it's a B2B as well as a B2C, where the, like, public can come and they can open their accounts, you know, all those sort of things.
How do you think that this industry will grow in future?
Footfall, we are expecting like an anywhere between like 5,000 to 6,000.
Okay.
For the 2 days put together, and when it, about growing the industry, like we are the pioneer in like a financial exhibition. We are the pioneer. Like this is the second edition of us. Okay. And one is like there is a business anyways, but the second thing like we want like people to understand the about the capital market. Okay, that's the reason why we are like putting the conferences where the retail investor session is one of them. So we want to inform people like hey, market is not only about a gambling. If you invest, you can make like a good wealth in your life.
How many times in a year do you want Fringe Bridge to hold exhibitions like this, or do you want them to happen annually, or do you want them to happen after every 6 months?
Yeah, I mean like we would definitely want to do it like say like more than once in a year. But at this point of time, like, we just planned like we will do like once in a year, okay? And if there is such demands comes up, we will definitely like double it.
We are standing with Mr. Abhay Arun Deshpande from Global Data Feeds. Hello, sir. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Okay, Mr. Deshpande, I would want to know about your company, and I would want to also know about your products.
Sure. What we do is we are distributors of real-time data of Indian exchanges. This is used by traders as well as brokerage houses as well as funds. They use this data into their analysis platforms, and this data helps them to take their investment decisions. We also distribute and develop B2B platforms which are used by brokers, and brokers can give these platforms to their end users, and their end users can use this platform. It's a comprehensive single platform. Using this single platform, they will be able to do their analysis, their decision making, as well as trade execution directly from single platform.
All right, fantastic. So tell me, what is it that you have to offer at this exhibition for your investors and for your consumers and your customers?
What happens mostly is the traders are normally not aware about what is currently going on in the market. They want to know about the exact trade price because they are day traders. So what we offer to them is tick by tick data. Using this real-time data, they are always up to the market. They are able to use the real-time prices, and their trading happens super fast than other traders who do trading on the basis of telephone.
What is the kind of footfall that you're expecting at this exhibition, FinBridge 2016?
We are quite optimistic, and we are quite excited to see this kind of crowd here, because normally we were a little skeptical because we were thinking that probably we may not get that kind of crowd because slightly away. But since morning we have seen so much of crowd, so I'm literally blown away, and I'm very positive about the response here.
We are standing with Mr. Sunil Vachare from Metropolitan Stock Exchange of India. Could you please tell me, how has the experience been at the exhibition till now, and what is it that you're looking at from this exhibition?
I mean, the crowd is coming in right now. It's just flowing in. A lot of investors are coming in. That's the best part. The individual investors are coming in and asking questions. And I'm sure by the end of the day, we'll have a large audience over here. And the seminars which are going on are quite informative too.
Sir, tell me something about your company.
Basically, we are a Metropolitan Stock Exchange. We were earlier called as MCXSX. We are the latest entry into the stock exchange. We are the third stock exchange. We are the youngest stock exchange. And basically, you know, we are trying to basically push in new products. Our main focus would be bringing in new products in the industry. We'll be focusing on ETFs and other products like debt market too. So basically, we are planning to bring about some kind of a differentiation in the whole setup.
How do you think this industry, financial services and technology industry, will boom in future? Do you think there is any scope for it?
In fact, there is a lot of scope. In fact, I would say, you know, it is about 10 to 15% people are participating in the financial markets. And I think a lot of investor education programs are required to, you know, educate the people.
All right, so thank you so much.